Welcome back, Mighty Mamas, and welcome if you are new. In today's video, I'm going to show you the best way to clean the middle of your oven glass door, and it's super easy for moms like you and me. So let's get right into it. Every change has a reason. Baby, let it come to you. Okay, Mamas, so let's talk for real now. How many of you have cleaned the outside of your oven door as well as the inside of your oven door, and you get it perfectly clean inside and you get it perfectly clean outside, but it still looks like that? It is still a mess in between the oven door, and that is exactly what I'm going to show you today. We are going to clean the middle of the oven door because the mess is not on the outside or the inside. It's actually in between the glass. I was completely mind blown when I first learned about this. I had no clue that this oven door can come off and that we can actually take this apart to clean in between the oven glass door. So I'm going to show you right now, step by step, how to do this. And I promise you, if I can do this, you can do this. So don't be scared. You can do it, Mama. Let's do this right now. Okay, so there are actually two ways you can do this. You can do it by removing the glass door and cleaning it on a flat surface, or you can keep the door attached and just clean it right here. I'm going to use the method of removing the door to clean it on a flat surface because I personally think that is the safest route to take, which, mind you, if you're going to try this, do it at your own risk. And also take note that if you are still under warranty with your stove, I would wait till the warranty is up because by taking this apart, you can actually void your warranty. So mine is pretty old. I've had this for over 15 years now, so there's no risk in me doing this myself. So you can always wait till your warranty is over before you attempt this, but always know that I'm here for you and you could come back to this video anytime to watch how this works. So in this case, I'm going to remove the door for you right now and I'm going to show you how to do that. So first you want to open the oven door. So if you look over here, there is a latch, and if you look over there, there is a latch. So there's two latches at the bottom of the oven door. Now I have the door opened all the way, and what I'm going to do is, you'll see here, this is like a pull down latch, which, hold on. Okay, what you're going to need is a little like screwdriver or flathead, something that can get in between here to open this because it will be closed all the way. So you just want to pull that out a little with your finger and then go ahead and stick your screwdriver or whatever it is in there to flick that down. So as you can see, this flicks up and down. I'm going to go ahead and do that over here as well. Okay, so now those are both unlatched and you want to put it all the way down. All the way down. That's important so that this doesn't get stuck in here. So make sure that's all the way down. And that's all the way down, push down. Okay, so now we're going to remove the oven door. Okay, so now we're gonna actually remove the oven door. And I know it seems scary, I know it does. And if you feel uncomfortable doing this alone, go ahead and ask a spouse or a friend or a family member to just give you that help or that emotional support if you need that. But I actually practiced this before making this video, so I got really comfortable with how my oven door works and what I actually need to take apart. So I recommend you just like doing step by step practicing before you try to just take it all apart and clean it. It's pretty easy once you do it. You'll be super surprised. And remember, if I could do this, you could do this. So we went ahead and we flipped the latches all the way down, and I'm just double checking they're like that so our door is completely open. So next we're going to raise the door up on an angle, and you're just going to hold it on each side. So I have a hand here holding the door, and I'm going to have my other hand here holding the door, and I'm just going to lift it straight up and out. And you can do one side. So you can do right, left, and see? It's as easy as that. And it's not that heavy. So I'm gonna go ahead and place this on my kitchen counter now. Okay, so now I have my oven door on my counter. I want to work on a flat surface. I just feel more safe that way because you have to be careful not to break the glass in between. So I just prefer to remove the door off. As you guys seen, it was super simple and easy to do for moms like you and me. So why not remove it and work on a flat space? So now what we're going to do is we're going to have to remove the first two top screws. Now I want you to know that when you remove this, this handrail will come off, as well as the this under part here. If I know on mine it comes off, but this is that part here, you know, like that has like the grooves in it. So this is really nice if you want to clean that space with those grooves in it that collect a lot of dust and debris and, you know, grease and things from cooking. So I'm gonna definitely be scrubbing that when I remove this. And I'm just going to need a Phillips screwdriver, which it all depends on your screw head. You have to look and see, but I'm just using a Phillips, and that's what a Phillips looks like. That's the way that looks. So, and then a flathead, this is a really tiny one, but a flathead is like that, where it's flat, just in case you guys didn't know. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove those now and show you how it works. Okay, also, I just want to point out, you want to hold this, the part right underneath the handle. So see how the handle is coming off? So the handle already came off, okay? So you just want to hold this part underneath and just lower it softly. And then I'm going to just remove this other screw. And you want to keep your washer, it'll probably come with a washer and a screw, like these. Just keep those together so you don't lose them, put them aside. Now we're just going to, I'll turn it this way for you. We're gonna just lift in between here. And this is the part we're going to clean. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to flip it over. Flip it over so that the front of the oven door is on the top. And now what you want to do is this part here, this plastic part, you want to lift it a little, put your hand underneath, and you're just going to pull this off. This is going to come off. And that's what I was talking about. You can take advantage of this time and clean in between these little spaces here. Okay, so I'm gonna use this Dawn Power Wash Spray. I love this stuff. It's a very good degreaser, and a lot of this is filled with grease. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna spray it on my rag, a wet rag. You don't wanna use paper towels because paper towels are made of wood and it could scratch your glass. So just use like cotton, regular rag, okay? For right now, I'm gonna go ahead and guess I'll come around here. So I'm gonna focus in on underneath here. I'm gonna start at the bottom and just clean underneath. This is where all that yucky grease was.
We gave it all, we say we love, we say we love. But we were just in a state until something better came along.
That outer piece with the groove marks in it, and all I used was the Dawn power wash spray with a scrubby brush. I highly recommend a scrubby brush because you want to get into those grooves. But you guys, just having that piece clean, that alone is so refreshing. I always try to clean in between those grooves and the handle would be in the way, so I can't actually get all the dust out like from the center ones. So now that I know I can do this, oh my gosh, this is a total game changer. This is just mind-blowing to me that we can remove our oven doors and we can clean in the middle of the oven door, and like we can do this by ourselves. Like, this is so super easy that anyone can do it, even moms like you and me. Like, mighty mama power, here we go. We could do anything, right? Speaking of that, if you are a little stressed out, just inhale, exhale. Just like my shirt says, here's another one of my tees from my Etsy shop, Mighty Mama Power. If you like it, go check out. It's for sale over there on my Etsy shop. Anyways, I am super excited to share with you guys the results of my oven door. It looks so beautiful. It's crystal clean. It's like brand new. And if you are a little timid to try this, I promise you, just get comfortable with your oven door before trying to do all the cleaning and everything. And I promise you, you can do it. If I could do this, you could do this. Just baby steps. Everything is baby steps. Start small. And before you know it, you have accomplished a huge task. I'm so proud of myself. So anyways, I'm gonna let that air dry and I'm just gonna do a once over with my microfiber on the outside and the inside between the middle of the oven door again, so that there is no debris or dust or anything. And then I'm just gonna piece everything back together again and put the oven door back on the oven. And then I will share with you guys the beautiful results. Let's go. Okay, so before I actually piece everything together, I want to share with you just how clean everything is now in here. I was able to vacuum up those coil pieces and then just wipe everything down inside, and it looks so good, you guys, so good. I will definitely be doing this on a regular basis.
Cover your eyes, promise not to look, 'cause I got some good news for you. Unexpected surprise, now you're on the hook. Guess what?
Okay, you guys, I wanted to share a little tip with you when it comes to removing the oven door and the latches. When I first tried this, I made an oopsie. It was something I didn't know about, and it freaked me out because this piece got stuck all the way deep down here, and I didn't know how to fix it, so I had to ask my husband to help me. And so we figured out a little bit of a hack, I guess you could call it, to help prevent that from happening. So when you open the latch at your oven before you remove the door, this is that cover, that latch that flicks open. You want to put it all the way down, which I did mention earlier, but the reason I mentioned that was because you want it to go inside here. Otherwise, the other part won't go all the way down, and so these will not be even when it comes to replacing the door back on the oven. So if for some reason yours gets stuck, and you'll know when it happens. So right now you may not know what I'm talking about, but if this happens to you where your latch gets stuck inside and this part of the latch is stuck up, all you need to do is take one of these wrenches, and you just want to stick it in your latch here, and then this will help. This can help by pulling it up. So you can pull it up with that. In this case, mine is locked into place the right way, so it doesn't need to come back up. But this is what you would do in the case where yours, where this part was all the way stuck down there and this latch was up. You would take this, and then you would just push up back down on it, and it would lift it out of that space. So I just wanted to share that with you in case any of you guys get one of yours stuck. I don't want you to freak out. There is that simple way to fix it. I feel stressed, I'm depressed, I feel stuck in a room. Guys, here is the finished results. You could totally see myself so clearly, even though my camera doesn't want to focus, but look at how crystal clear that is. And I would turn the oven light on if I had a working light bulb. I actually need to get a new one. But as you can see, it is clean on the inside of the oven door when I first started. And then I did have the outside clean as well, but now it is clean in between the oven door. It is clean in the middle of the oven door, and so it looks perfectly brand new. And I am telling you guys, this is the best way to clean the middle of your oven door. So I highly recommend that you try it. And let's look in between those grooves. Look at how clean they are. Oh my gosh, they are sparkling clean. But oh my gosh, I am just so blown away by how clean my oven door is now. So remember, if I can do this, you can do this. This is definitely the best way to clean the middle of your oven door. So give it a try. Let me know in the comments below if you try it out and how it went for you. Thanks for watching, mamas. And I will be back next week with another one for you. Remember, small steps lead to big results. Have a nice day.